यस, गुड इवनिंग, गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन।
गुड
सो
इवनिंग सर।
गुड इवनिंग सर। सो टुडे वी आर गोना स्टार्ट विद द कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री। सो लेट मी शेयर द स्क्रीन विदाउट एनी डिले। लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड द सेशन। हाँ, एवरीवन शुड टर्न ऑन योर कैमरा। हाँ, कैन यू एबल टू सी द स्क्रीन हियर?
सर आई स्विच ऑन माय कैमरा। यस आई एम एबल टू सी।
यस सर वी कैन।
Yes, look at this here. Coordinate geometry. In the first, look at this here. In coordinate geometry, first we are going to talk about Cartesian system. First, before starting the Cartesian system, let me ask you what exactly the coordinate geometry is all about. How many of you know the definition of coordinate geometry? Why do we learn coordinate geometry basically? Anyone of you, please tell me.
Sir, I learned coordinate geometry last year, so I know.
I'm not asking you when did you learn. Just tell me what did you learn from that.
Sir, like I learned
the point.
Anyone. See, Bhargav is talking. Bhargav is supposed to tell. If someone is
sir,
talking.
Sir, I learned about the Cartesian plane and coordinate axis, and then I learned about the abscissa and the ordinate. Then I learned about the quadrants, the Cartesian plane. Then I also learned how to plot different points on a graph paper.
Yes, sir, like 5-1, 5-2, 3-5.
Okay, great. Huh. Basically, now let me ask you what is coordinate geometry? I'm not asking you what did you learn from the coordinate geometry. I'm asking you that what is coordinate geometry?
Coordinate geometry is the type of geometry which is done on a graph paper, the Cartesian plane, while plotting other points in a Cartesian plane and then joining them to make shapes.
Great. See, coordinate geometry, basically coordinate geometry also called as analytic geometry. What is this?
Analytic
geometry. Clear. So basically, coordinate geometry is a study of geometry using coordinate points. What is that? Coordinate geometry is a study of. Let me write here. I'm just writing simple, simple steps. One second. Who is joining? Aditya is joining. Study of geometry using the coordinate points. Clear? Huh. See, what are the applications of coordinate geometry? Now let us talk about what are the applications of coordinate geometry. What are the reasons? What are the things? What are the things made us to learn coordinate geometry basically? Why we are learning coordinate geometry? Tell me. Anyone of you?
So it can be helpful in architecture.
In architecture, very good.
And in marking the places, like using latitudes and longitudes.
Great. Great. See, by using coordinate geometry, we can find out the distance between two points. For suppose, Piyush home is here and Bhargav home is here. Piyush is here, Bhargav is here. What is the distance between these two guys? What is the distance between the Piyush home and Bhargav's home? We can find out. One second. Bhargav, I'm talking, right? Please don't talk. You should not interrupt. Don't interrupt in between. Please. Let me talk. Once I'm done with that, you ask. Huh. We can find out the distance between two points. This is my Piyush's home. This is Bhargav's home. We can find out the distance between these two points by using coordinate geometry basically. we can find out, we can divide two lines. We can divide two lines. Let me write here. One second, let me open the note. Just a minute, children, just a minute. Look at this here. By using what? We are learning coordinate geometry today, right? Coordinate geometry. By using coordinate geometry, what are the things we can make it out? Finding the distance between two points, isn't it? And what dividing two lines, or dividing any lines, right? Dividing lines in m is to n ratio. Finding the midpoint of a line, calculating the area of a triangle in the Cartesian plane. I would say these are the applications of coordinate geometry. What is this? Applications. I would say this is applications of coordinate geometry. Clear, children? Is there any doubt? Any doubt? See, by using coordinate geometry, we can find out the distance between two points, dividing the lines in mx to n ratio. All right. Finding midpoint of a particular line, calculating the area of a triangle. Well, suppose if I have this area, I can find out. If I have the triangle, I can find out the area of the triangle in a Cartesian plane. Clear? Now, look at this here. First, in coordinate geometry, let us talk about Cartesian system. What is it? Cartesian system. What exactly the meaning of coordination system? Cartesian system, you know, tells us to learn about Cartesian plane and coordinate axis. What is Cartesian plane? Cartesian plane, look at the definition. The Cartesian plane is defined two perpendicular number lines. What is that? Two perpendicular number lines. Look at this here. If I draw this line and this line, look at this. This is my x-axis, this is my y-axis. This is my horizontal, this is my vertical line. Two perpendicular lines. This is what called as Cartesian plane, basically. A Cartesian plane is defined by what? Cartesian plane defined by using these two perpendicular lines. What is that? By using these two perpendicular lines. So the horizontal line is called as what? X-axis. And the vertical line is called as what? What? This is my y-axis. Horizontal is x-axis. Vertical is y-axis. As simple as that. Clear? Now, these lines are called as coordinate axes. What is that? These lines. This horizontal line and this vertical line. Lines are called as coordinate axes. Cartesian plane is named after French mathematician René Descartes. What is his name? René Descartes. So he only formalized in mathematics how to use Cartesian plane, how to use this kind of, you know, coordinate axis, basically. Clear? He only formalized that Cartesian plane and all. Clear? Any doubt here? So here the name of the mathematician is not important. Understanding the concept is very important. Why we are using this coordinate system? What exactly we are learning from this, you know, Cartesian system and Cartesian plane, I would say that. Clear? Any doubt? Any doubt, guys?
No, sir.
Guys, am I going fast? Am I talking fast? Are you getting?
No, sir.
Are you getting my
point? No, sir.
Are you
able? Yes, I'm getting your point clearly.
Yes, thank you. See, if you are not understanding anything, please try to ask me here. Clear? If you are not.
Sir, that's an application.
Yes, yes, I'll teach you one second, not an issue. Look at this here, origin. And one more thing, Cartesian plane we have learned here. What is Cartesian plane? Cartesian plane is defined by what? Two perpendicular number lines. Horizontal line is called as x-axis and vertical line is called as y-axis, as simple as that. So these lines are called as coordinate axes. What is it? These lines are called as coordinate axes, basically. Clear? So look at this now. We'll be talking about origin. One more terminology. What are the terminologies we have learned here? What is Cartesian plane and what is origin here? What is origin? The coordinate axes intersect each other at right angles. The point of intersection of these two axes is called as origin, as simple as that. Clear, guys? So what does it mean? What is origin? Origin means point of intersection of these two perpendicular lines. This is my origin. Origin can be denoted by the symbol called O. Clear? O. This is my O. Origin. Clear? This is my x-axis. This is my y-axis. This is my x-axis. Clear? So x-axis and y-axis. So origin is what? Basically coordinate axis. Intersect each other at right angles. This is my right angle. You can look at this here. Right angle. All 90 degrees. We'll be having here 90 degrees, isn't it? The coordinate axis intersect each other at right angles. The point of intersection of these two lines is called as origin. As simple as that. Getting my point, children? Any doubt? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Now we'll talk about what is quadrants, basically. We'll talk about quadrants. Quadrants. What exactly the meaning of quadrants? The Cartesian plane is divided into four equal parts. How many equal parts? See, Cartesian plane, I told you now, this is my y-axis. This is my x-axis. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
These two perpendicular lines. This Cartesian plane. This is total. This LMA called as what? This total is called as what? Cartesian plane. This Cartesian plane further divided into four parts. So that is called as quadrant. Quadrant. What is the meaning of quad? Quad means four. Clear? That is what the reason we got that name quadrant. Clear? Any doubt?
Yes.
Quadrant means four. See here, how many quadrants I have here? Four quadrants. What are they? This is my first quadrant. This is my second quadrant. This is my third quadrant. And this is my fourth quadrant. Total four quadrants I have over here. Clear? Look at this here. These are named in order as 1, 2, 3, 4, starting with upper right and going around anti-clockwise direction. Look at this here. That is what he's saying. This is my first quadrant. In first quadrant, plus I'll be having. Look at this here. Why we are writing plus here? Tell me. Why? Because x-axis and y-axis. Look at this here.
Because here we are only positive values.
Yes. Look at this. This is a positive here. This is also positive here. So here plus and plus. Look at this now. Second quadrant. What is x-axis here? Negative. What is y-axis here? Positive.
Y-axis positive, sir.
What is third quadrant? Negative, comma negative. X and y both are negative. What is fourth quadrant? X-axis is positive. Y-axis is negative. So this is what? This is what? The content of quadrant, basically. What is that? This is what the points of quadrant. Is there any doubt in the quadrant, please?
For this, we need to take a graph.
Yes. You need graph for this. You know, without graph also, you can just do that. But if you have graph, so you can understand clearly. You can understand that clearly. Clear my point. If you have graph, if you draw in a graph, you'll be able to understand that point and about this Cartesian plane, about this quadrant system, clearly you'll be able to understand. Clear? Any doubt?
No.
Look at this now. First, points in different quadrants. See, in a first quadrant, signs of coordinates of points in different quadrants. So we will be having different signs in different coordinates. Clear? So look at this. In first quadrant, I'll be x coordinate is positive, y coordinate is also positive. All right. Clear? And second quadrant, x coordinate will be positive, y coordinate will be negative. Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Second quadrant, first will be having x is negative, y is positive. Third quadrant, x is negative, y is positive. Y is also negative, third quadrant. Fourth is what? Positive, negative, like this. Positive, positive, first quadrant. Here, negative, positive here. Here, negative, comma, negative. Here, positive, comma, negative. So, this is what he is talking about. See, I just told you diagrammatically, graphically, he's just writing in a theoretically. He's just writing theoretically. That is what the difference basically. Clear? Any doubt? Any doubt, guys? Any
doubt
here?
No, sir. No doubt.
Very simple. Very simple. Look at this now. Plotting on a graph. Now, plotting on a graph. How to plot a point on a graph, basically. So today, entire session will be of. Today, entire session will be discussing of about you know basics. How to you know plot a point on a graph. What is Cartesian plane? What is coordinate axis? What is x-axis, y-axis? What are the quadrant system is all about? All right. So this is what we'll be discussing in today's session. In tomorrow's session, I mean like in the, from next session onwards, we'll be learning of, we'll learning about the problems. We'll be solving the problems and all. Clear? So look at this here. Representation of a point on a Cartesian plane. See your school teachers definitely will teach you this coordinate geometry. See, since it is a private, you know, tuition for you guys, so that is the reason, you know, I'm just going somewhat in a short way. Clear? Your school teachers will be different. Your school teacher will be teaching in a different way. Why? Because they'll be going each and every concept with a problematic. Clear? Yeah. So we'll finish. Sorry?
My school teacher has teached this chapter.
Finished?
Yes, sir. Finished. Also.
Okay, very good. Not an issue. See here. So let us revise it again. Not an issue. Look at this here. So that is what I'm telling you. That's what I'm telling you now. First, we'll learn basics, then we'll go for the problems. Clear? So representation of a point on a Cartesian plane. So first of all, if I draw, this is my Cartesian plane, X. Let me show you 1 second.
16 minutes.
Who is that? Hey, who is that? Who is that? Who is singing? If you do not have interest, I'll simply throw you out. You're not allowed to be stay in the session actually if you are singing so. Who is that? May I know what's your name?
Sorry, sir. My sister was watching the movie. I told her to go.
Please sit away from your, you know, sisters and brothers. They might disturb you guys. Once you're done with that, you can just meet them. Clear? Yeah. So representation of a point on Cartesian plane, basically. Look at this here. This is my x-axis, this is my y-axis, as simple as that. Like, so what I told you, the midpoint, the point of intersection of these two axes, this is origin. Let us denote it. Oh, so what will be my point here? 0, 0. Clear? So look at this. If I write any point like 2, 3, what exactly the first point tells to me? The 2 is
positive.
First point shows, no, first point represent x coordinate. What is this? X coordinate. This is my y coordinate. Clear? X coordinate and y coordinate. So if I ask you to plot -2, 4 on Cartesian plane, how would you be able to plot
on
it?
Quadrant 3.
Look at this.
Quadrant 2, sir.
1 second.
Quadrant 2, sir.
1 second. I didn't ask anyone, right? 1 second. If I ask anyone, please you just tell me. See here, -2, 4. How can I plot here? -2 is my x coordinate. So minus will be what? Minus will be here. So let me draw here. -1, -2, -3, -4, and so on. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and so on. Here, 1, 2, 3, and so on. Here, 1, so -1, -2, -3, and so on. Clear? So this is how my, you know, graph will be basically. So he is asking us to plot -2, 4. X coordinate is -2. So I'll be taking this one. And my 4 will be here, right? So -2, 4. -2 will be here. I supposed to take this distance. And 4 is here. So this is my 4. Clear? Any doubt? This is my -2, 4. So this is my area. Tell me.
Sir, can you repeat it again?
Definitely. 1 second. 1 second. I'll repeat you again. See here. minus 2. First x coordinate is what? This is my x axis, right? This horizontal one is x axis. So first I suppose to take x coordinate. What is my x coordinate here? Minus 2. Minus 2 I'm taking here. What is my y coordinate? Which is 4. Right? So 4 is here and minus 2 is here. So my point is, this point is what? This point is minus 2 comma 4. If I ask you to plot one more point, let us say 2 comma 3, we'll plot now 2 comma 3. Let us plot 2 comma 3 now. How can we plot here? 2 comma 3, how can we plot 2 comma 3? First x coordinate, and this is my y coordinate. X coordinate is what? 2. 2 is here, right? And y coordinate is what? 3 here. So
3, sir.
You have to take this point here. So this is my 2 comma 3 point. No need of drawing these, you know, these lines actually. For your understanding purpose, I'm just drawing that. So straight away you can draw that. Clear? So this is my 2 comma 3 point. Clear? This point. Clear? This point is 2 comma 3. If I ask you to draw minus 1 comma minus 2. Minus 1 comma minus 2. Look at this here. How can I draw that? Minus 1 comma minus 2. Let me change the color.
So minus 1 on x-axis.
Look at this here. Minus 1 on x-axis. X-axis. So x-axis is minus 2 is here. So my point will be something here. Look at this here. My point will be something here. So this is my point, which is minus 1 comma minus 2. Any doubt here now? Any doubt here? Tell me.
No, sir.
Yes. So this is what the basic information of plotting on a graph. What plotting a point on a graph. Clear? Plotting the coordinates on a graph. Plotting x and y coordinates on a Cartesian plane. Anything you can call it. Representation of a point on a Cartesian plane. So using coordinate axis, we can describe any point in the plane using an ordered pair of numbers. A point A is represented by an ordered pair x comma y, where x is abscissa and O. Okay. See here, what he is telling is, see, everyone knows here. How many of you know what is ordered pair? Ordered pair is here x and y can be called as an ordered pair. X and y can be called as what? Ordered pair. So this is my unordered pair now. This is my ordered pair. Ordered pair. See here, x coordinate is called as abscissa and y coordinate is called as ordinate. Getting my point? X coordinate is called as abscissa and y coordinate is called as ordinate. Clear my point, children? Any doubt? No. So already you might have learned in your 7th standard itself. These all are the, ordered pairs concept and the Cartesian.
8th standard.
Sorry?
Also.
Very good. So this is what the basic information. So plotting a point. So just now I told you about how to plot a point on a graph. So this and all in a basic system. Let us take examples, whatever he has given here. So he has given 3 comma 2. Let us draw 3 comma 2. X axis, Y axis. This is also X, Y. So let us take now 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4. So this is what the basic graph. So first we'll plot 3 comma 2. Where can I plot 3 comma 2? 3 is here, 2 is here. On x-axis, I supposed to take 3, this distance. On a y-axis, I must take 2, 1, 2, this distance. So this is my point here. 3 comma 2. Clear? Clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Similarly, minus 2 comma 3 and minus 1 comma minus 2. Similarly, minus 2 comma 3, minus 1 comma 2. How can you plot it out? One second. Minus 2 comma 3. Where is my minus 2? Here on x axis. And 3. Minus 2 is here. 3 is here. So this distance. So this is my point of minus 2 comma 3. Clear? So minus 1 comma 2, minus 1 comma minus 2. This is my minus 1 comma minus 2. Here. This is my minus 1 comma minus 2. Any doubt? Any doubt, guys? Any doubt? Very simple.
No, sir. No doubt.
Very
simple. No doubts. Very simple. Ah. So this is what a basic system of your coordinate geometry. I mean, like introduction of coordinate geometry, I would say. Clear? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. Let us solve the problems of coordinate geometry. Okay. I'll be sharing these notes with you guys. Don't worry. Look at this. One second. See, very simple question. Already we have solved the questions. One second. Just a minute. Guys, look at this here. Everyone solve this question? Everyone solve this question? In which quadrant? Which quadrant? Tell me.
First one is fourth quadrant.
One second, let me.
Close third quadrant.
The first one is third
quadrant. The first one is third quadrant. Second one is fourth.
Second one, fourth quadrant. Third quadrant.
This is my which quadrant? Fourth quadrant.
Fourth.
This is my
second.
Which quadrant?
Second quadrant.
This is my third quadrant.
Third.
Look at this here. Let us verify. If they ask you to verify this by using your Cartesian plane, how would you be able to verify this? By using the Cartesian plane. Let me just draw this. Look at this here. Let me draw somewhat bigger here. Yes. This is my 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and goes on. Okay. Minus 1, minus 2. Minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, and goes on dash. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 8, and goes on. So look at this here now again. Here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, minus 8. Look at this here. How can you plot this? So first minus 2 comma minus 4. How can I verify minus 2 comma on x-axis minus 2? First, one second. So what was answer? My answer was, this was my third quadrant. This was my fourth quadrant. This was my second quadrant.
This and was third.
third quadrant again. So let us verify whether it is correct or not. So minus 2 come up, minus 4. So minus 2 I have here, minus 4 I have here. So this is mine. So I will be having here, right? So minus 2 comma minus 4, third quadrant. So next 3 comma minus 1. So where I'll be having?
Sir, three? I have a doubt.
1 second. 3 comma minus 1.
The quadrant 4.
3 is here. And x coordinate is 3. Minus 1. Y coordinate is minus 1. So I'll be having here. 3 comma minus 1. Clear? So next. Minus 1 comma 5. Minus 1 comma 5. Minus 1 is here. 5. Y coordinate is 5. So this is my y axis. This is my x axis, right? So minus 1 comma 5. So this will be the answer. Minus 1 comma 5. Clear?
Yes, sir. No doubt.
Next. Minus 3 comma minus 8. Minus 3 comma minus 8. Minus 3 comma minus 8. How can you do that?
So minus 3 on x-axis and minus 8 on y-axis.
It will be in third quadrant.
Third quadrant.
How can you make a point? Tell me, minus 3 comma minus 8. X coordinate is minus 3. X coordinate is minus 3, y coordinate is also minus. So
quadrant 3, sir.
Yeah, it's quadrant 3, it will be here somewhere. This one, right?
Yes, sir.
Minus 3 comma minus 8. And Sujay was asking the doubt. Tell me, Sujay.
Sir, I didn't understand. How are you determining coordinates?
How am I? First, I'm taking x coordinate and y coordinate. I'm yes, just sir. Plotting on that. See here. That is what we were explaining. Now you are asking, what did he do in previous question?
Sir, I did get it, but I don't get how you're determining for like separate ones.
Separate?
Yes, sir. You gave a lot of them, right? I didn't get how you're doing.
See here. What I'm saying is, first, if I have 2 comma 3, here, what is my x coordinate? X coordinate is 2, y coordinate is 3, right?